Hey there, have you seen my latest video, Jupiter Gets Emotional? Come check it out at soulmart.me. Namaste, and welcome to Soul Horoscopes Orbis Edition. From my webcam to yours, I'm Christopher Ray Mamwateki, your astrologer and soul biographer, here to help you put the pieces of your karmic story together. And please forgive my absence the last 4 weeks. I have been facing my own karmic story, which has been repeating and repeating for the last year. So thank you to all those who sent good support, love, and your prayers. I really appreciate it. I got all the notes, everything. Thank you very much. So let's talk about what's going on. Have you had ascension sickness? That's what we call it when you have to grow super fast. When the spirit grows faster than the body, we get sick. Let's look at Mr. Orbits Man. Now, I don't know if you know this, but the planets all align with the chakras. And this map here shows you how each planet aligns with each chakra. Well, the chakra that's been giving us a sick stomach literally has been the third chakra, which is our yellow chakra. That's because thoughts and feelings come together there. Now, for the last year, Jupiter was in Gemini, expanding thoughts and throwing off the two in their balance. Now, Jupiter's in Cancer, having emotions expand and perhaps throwing them away from thoughts. So, put simply, if you're having ascension sickness, having problems eating, which may lead to problems sleeping, really what you need to do is align your thoughts with your feelings, get those two on the same side. Now, the sun is moving into Leo, which means we're working on the heart chakra, that beautiful green one there, and that means we'll be working on it for the next 2 months. You may not know this, but Chiron also rules the heart chakra along with the sun. So, healing, loving, being in the moment, that's what it's about. But let's look at the planets and what caused all this shift, shall we? Here's a sneak peek. Womp womp! That's right. That's Monday, if you don't know. And there's so much going on, I have to layer it piece by piece. It really begins with a soul pyramid. We got a soul pyramid in Earth starting off the week. That's going to allow us to change reality rapid fire and fast. On top of that, a soul pyramid in water, a grand trine aligning our emotions so we get used to the way it feels right away as well. A yod pointing to the sun pulls in our intuition and our ability to kill things into love. That's basically a creation yod right there. You can't put it any simpler than that. Then we've got an opposition, a little tug of war between Saturn and the moon. Two more oppositions and a square. That's the one between Uranus and Pluto. We've been feeling that one for a long time. Another square between Uranus and Black Lilith. Oh, that's fun. One more square between the sun and the moon, so feelings and our love isn't talking to each other. And one more square. I love is not talking to boundaries. So all these parts of us are talking to us with the trines. All these parts of us are in fights with each other or ourselves, and that's what I'm going to talk about. When we get up in the ascension elevator and get up to the clouds, I'm going to talk about what this means for each of the 12 zodiacs in your rising signs and how it turns into happiness or not happiness for you. Look at that spiral graph. It's so pretty. All right, let's not wait any further. Let's take the ascension elevator and take a better look at you.
Folks, this is your captain speaking. We realize you have a choice in the astrologers you choose to fly with. We just like to thank you for flying with Christopher Wateki.
Hello, Libras and Libra risings, and welcome to 33,000 feet for a bird's eye view of you. And forgive me for being off the air for so long. It was an intense time. Jupiter moving from Gemini into Cancer. A very powerful shift in consciousness. A very powerful shift in what we've had to do. And for you, a shift from your focus. You spent about a year learning with Jupiter in Gemini from 2012 to 2013. And this year, you will begin a one-year expansion of your emotional feelings about your future and your legacy on the planet, which is also known as your career. Now, you may not know this, but for Librans and Libra risings, pretty much as a peace artist, your career is human development. That's what Cancer energy is, developing humans. But the question is, are you developing yourself more than humans? Because that's the way the universe set it up, for you to take care and nurture yourself before others. And this is where Librans and Libra risings have gotten really confused, where they put other people before themselves, and so there's less to give. So it's going to be an intense time. You're going to find bad decisions blowing up in your face. You're going to find conflicts in your career if it hasn't happened already. And you're going to find that when it comes to career alliances, you begin to change teams. That is with intensity probably over July 4th weekend. But now with the sun in Leo, all that Cancer emotion career stuff has shifted to a 1 month exploration of where you belong. We're in chapter one of Sun in Leo, and you're now working on your context consciousness. This is how you feel you contextualize yourself in the world. Now, you're supposed to file yourself according to the loving decimal system. Where you love is where you belong. But if Librans have been doing things for other people and things they don't love, you may find yourself surrounded by strangers, people who aren't really your friends, groups and associations that you don't want to associate with. And that's because you weren't listening to your own heart. So we're looking for where you have unlawful attachments to other people. Unlawful meaning you did it to get ahead or something, not because your heart wanted it. And that is the first context of chapter one. Now, the sun is in Leo, and it's going to move from step 5 to step 11. So you'll have some intense conversations, a lot of introverted thinking about where you belong. But by the end of the week, you will feel like it's starting to heal. Now, Mercury, Mars, and Jupiter, and Black Lilith, they're all working on your career consciousness still. Mercury will get to a point where you believe you're headed for where you want to go with career, but Jupiter there for a full year means you will not know about career until next summer. So you really got to work with the universe, work with yourself, and be patient. Saturn in Scorpio is direct at step 5. Now, this is what's pushing for you to get what you're worth. That's a whole nother story going on in the background since last October. Telling Libras and Libra risings you deserve more, that means you had to cut away where you had parasites on your consciousness, where you were giving it away. This, of course, is in complete concert with taking care of yourself first and feeling where you belong. So when at least it comes to thoughts, you must keep in mind, be mindful of what you are worth right now. Then finally, Pluto is retrograding Capricorn. Now this is opposing all that Cancer energy and career. So directly opposing all your career energy is this other force saying, if you want the career that you want, you've got to think differently and change the rules about how much you nurture yourself. And nurturing yourself is a key component. So nurturing yourself, being there for yourself emotionally, having the home foundation, having the sleep foundation necessary, those basics are what Pluto retrograde at 9 degrees are putting the finishing touches on for Librans and Libra risings. So let's take a first look at last week and what happened. The biggest thing that happened last week really began with the full moon. We had a full moon in Aquarius that was a tug of war, the sun moving into Leo. That was a tug of war between what your heart wants and what society was telling you to do. Now, the little clue was your heart. Listen to your heart, because you belong wherever your heart feels you belong. And if you're a quirky person and you only belong at like comic book as a comic book convention, I can't get that out, that's where you belong. Those are your people. So some hard realities, and then over the weekend, some breakdowns. This last weekend, a triple breakdown, 3 days. This was a breakdown of a friendship, breakdown of a reputation, really breakdown of something in society keeping you from what your heart truly wants. And that brings us to this week. This week, we will dive, basically be exploring. I mean, the first part of the week is exploring, then finalizing. And what you're exploring is where you do not belong. But what we're diving into is spirituality. Jupiter's at 7 degrees all week long. And with Neptune at 4 degrees retrograde in Pisces, this means we have potential spiritual miracles where Jupiter opens up ideas and Neptune fortifies it. All right, so these ideas deal with new career options. So believe it or not, in this desire to figure out where you belong, you might get the clues you needed for your career and legacy. So perhaps that was what was missing. This has to do with the way you see yourself in society, the way you title yourself in society. So title is very much tied to career, especially promotions and whatnot. You'll want to meditate on Tuesday and Wednesday the most. That's where it'll be the most cloudy, and that's where spiritual miracles can happen. I'm speaking, of course, with where you belong, perhaps a friendship that's going under right now, anything like that. That's what you'll want to pray about. Now, with Neptune retrograde, you must pray. The universe is not going to send you an email out of nowhere. A retrograde means you must go within and do it on your own. So some real prayer and meditation. Now, with Jupiter in Cancer, this could all also be very career-based, and so you may be obsessed with career because the two are kind of tied together. But by Thursday, the skull and crossbones means it's time to decide what goes. That includes what friendships go, what associations, what alliances, etc. What your heart is not connected to. Basically, just deciding against what your heart's not into. Friday, we take action on that, so send the email, tell the person. And on Saturday, you are trusting and loving and holding space. So Saturday is a manifestation day. What you're manifesting is a new plateau, a new belonging. And that new belonging isn't necessarily representing the heights of where you will go, but it's representing how you will no longer go below a certain kind of jurisdiction. This might be you moving from a blue-collar to a green-collar worker or a blue-collar to a white-collar worker. This may be you saying you don't belong, giving it away anymore. Anything under the sun your heart doesn't belong with, but it does affect your reputation in society, so it tends to be friendship and society sort of transit. Now, taking a sneak peek at next week, Sunday will be a yin-yang feel-good day, so you're going to heal. It's a good day to go out. It's a very social day, August 4th. So if you have a social event, it should go very well. But the turning point next week that we will talk about is Lightcast Day on Tuesday the 6th. That's when we have a Uranus rule breakdown breakthrough and a real possible spiritual miracle to manifest. Jupiter is saying decide and act on that career. So you want to decide and act on career by Tuesday. We'll talk more about that when I come back next week. Before I do come back, I do want to ground real quick and bring it to Earth and tell you about a couple of things. One is Jupiter Gets Emotional, my new video that's downloadable at soulmart.me. This will give you a six-month perspective on that career, diving deep into the dates month after month, helping you with the turning points and helping you leverage those against the other issues going on, like the inner child, take care of yourself, all that stuff, soul capital. If you don't like video, well, I made it MP3 now, so you can listen to me while you're in the gym. You can also get the Act 2 videos, if you don't have one, for just $3.99 now. They're on sale and price to go, so pick one of those up while you're down. And you have till the end of the month if you want the $99.99 reading sale price for me, yours truly, where I can connect with you for 1 hour, and I'll give you a serious joy plan for that career and more. So come check it out. These are all available at soulmart.me. One last invitation. Come on down if you haven't checked me out already with Practical Wizardry. This is my guided hangout that is live at 6 p.m. Eastern Time on Wednesdays, on Hump Day. You'll find Soul Garden has a whole group of people helping you through the hump. A happy Hump Day. But come on down. I'm teaching you how to step into your magic, and right now we're talking about the magic of love. So for Librans out there trying to draw a lover, this is the class for you. All right, Your Honor, that's all I have for this week. I will see you in 1 week with more. Until then, live, love, be.